The issue first came to light overnight when it emerged that the Electoral Commission remote polling team didn't make its scheduled trip to Elko Island. The AEC says its delayed flight meant the team couldn't meet up with its four-wheel drive transport on the island. It's also confirmed it's been unable to facilitate scheduled voting in other remote communities in the Northern Territory.
We're really concerned about this news today, and I think what it boils down to is really voter suppression. The failure to have remote polling booths open for election day means that, you know, thousands of Blackfellas and people up in these electorates won't have their say on this election.
Now the AEC has revealed polling stations at 78 locations across four jurisdictions could be affected. All of them in regional or remote parts of Queensland, South Australia and Western Australia, with large numbers of Aboriginal voters. The seats of Capricornia, Flynn, Kennedy and Leichhardt in Queensland, Barker and Grey in South Australia and Durack and O'Connor in Western Australia.
We know that these electorates that they've announced today have a really high proportion of First Nations votes, and so we're really concerned about that.
The AEC wasn't available for interview. In a statement, it said it's attempting to get the vote to as many remote Australians as possible, adding the vast majority of the 7,000 polling places will be in operation. It says some towns and communities have as few as 20 enrolled voters. Sarah Collard, SBS World News.